And welcome back to Hannity. So comedian Kathy Griffin may have apologized for crossing the line with her vile photo shoot where she held a severed head of somebody resembling the president. But today she blamed a lot of people for trying to take her down, playing the victim. Really? Watch this.
I'm not afraid of Donald Trump. He's a bully. I've dealt with older white guys trying to keep me down my whole life, my whole career. A sitting president of the United States and his grown children and the First Lady are personally, I feel, personally trying to ruin my life forever. Forever. My impression is that they have mobilized their armies or their bots or whatever they do. Like I said, it's quite clear to me that they're trying to use me as a distraction, and I'm not going to be collateral damage for this fool. I saw the tide turning and I saw what they were doing. And I went, oh, okay, they're trying to spin this and they're making it about Barron. And obviously that was never my intent. I would never want to hurt anyone, much less a child. But I started to see what was really happening. And then it was a mob mentality pylon. There's a bunch of old white guys trying to silence me. And I'm just here to say that's wrong.
She said in December she'd go after an 11-year-old kid. Joining us now from the Fox Business Network, our sister network, Lou Dobbs is with us. I don't even know where to begin here. You know, the fact that she's blaming men. If I was a man, this wouldn't have happened. She's blaming Trump and his family after his 11-year-old kid had to see this grotesque image of her posing like an ISIS fighter having just beheaded somebody. Is she serious?
Well, she apparently is serious. And she is. I think the president gets the last word on Kathy Griffin. His tweet ended with the word sick. Sick is her performance since that very sick and appalling stunt that she pulled. And this press conference, Sean, I have to disagree with you a bit. I think conservatives, Republicans, all decent Americans should pay for her to stay on the road doing this day after day with Lisa Bloom. You see the rancid soul of the left in almost every word she utters. I think she should be on display. I think there should be a loop on cable television.
I don't know if I can handle the loop part, but I'll say this. You know, her career's every liberal snowflake in the country. She goes from a D-list comedian to at least a C-minus. They're all going to want to see her because of this.
I think you're going to see something that is unprecedented. I think you're going to see instead, Sean, and I'm serious, I think you're going to see the left, you're going to see Hollywood, academia, all begging her to get the hell off the air, to just shut up for a while.
Because No. I want her to stay out there.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Yeah. But the left is going to be running the boycott against her.
I know. And where did this come from? Old white men. Where did it come from? The Trumps are trying to destroy me? How did she flip this?
I practice
martial arts. This is great jujitsu.
It was great jujitsu, judo. It may throw a little taekwondo because she's basically blaming the president for having one of the great families in all of American politics. How dare him have children who love him and admire him
and stick up for their family and their little brother.
How dare him do that? Let me ask you this.
You know, I got to be honest. I stick up for my friends in life.
And you bet.
I accepted her apology until this insanity, and I still accept it because I'm not like these liberal fascists wanting a silent speech I don't like. I'm not like them. I haven't been my whole career.
Right.
But I'm looking at like Anderson Cooper. I'm like, Anderson, grow a spine. You know what? Stick up for your friend. Accept her apology. What is it with people? There's such disloyalty and a lack of conviction. Everybody's afraid of how it impacts them in life.
This is wonderful, Sean. We're seeing who these people really are.
And we're seeing
why they're not conservatives. They're not, the stuff of this country. The American way.
When you got on the fire at CNN, I called you.
You were absolutely.
Remember, you were on the- I called Lou. I said, hang in there. Don't worry. Don't let him get you down.
I've been praying for you that you'll get through the weekend staying employed.
Thanks for praying, Lou. It's worked. So far, we're surviving thanks to my audience. But,
well,
all right. I got to roll, my friend.
Have a great weekend. You too, Sean.
Oh, bye. Coming up on this busy Friday breaking news night tonight on Hannity.
Compliance with the terms of the Paris Accord and the onerous energy restrictions that is placed on the United States could cost America as much as 2.7 million lost jobs by 2025.
President Trump fulfilling a major campaign promise and announcing that he will pull the U.S. out of the Paris Climate Agreement. Liberals, they are freaking out because guess what? It may save American jobs. And guess what? China and India are exempt? Seriously? We'll get reaction. Larry Elder will join us. And then later, even Hillary Clinton's allies in the press are starting to say, maybe it's your fault. Dr. Gina Loudon, Corey Lewandowski, and part two of my interview with the Vice President Mike Pence as he answers the question, governing in the age of the destroy Trump media and Russia, Russia, Russia on this busy night.